OpenAI has launched new audio models in their API. So they have launched two models for speech to text. So as you can see here, they are launching GPT-4o transcribe and the mini version of that. So we are going to make use of this particular model to convert our audio file into text. So let's get started. First thing, make sure that you are having an account in ChatGPT or OpenAI. So just Google OpenAI API, you'll be getting this official website. Click here, and I have already signed in. If you don't have, you must sign in, and you must also have some credits added because OpenAI API is not free, it is paid. Once you have done that, to the top you'll be having your profile. Click that and go to your profile, and here you'll be having the API keys which we'll be requiring. And to the top over here, we are having the documentation. So open this in a new tab, and in documentation, we'll be having the normal chat code, how you can use it. Under specialized models, you'll be having speech to text. Click here, and as you can see here, these are the two models that they recently launched, and they're having two endpoints. One is for transcriptions and another one is for translations. Transcription is basically converting our audio file into the text format, and translation is you'll be having an audio file in one language and you'll be getting the text translated into another language. But this particular translation feature is only available for Whisper model. It's not, I guess, available for GPT-4o mini transcribe, because as you can see here, translations, this endpoint supports only the Whisper 1 model. So only transcriptions, which is converting speech to text, is available for GPT-4o model. And here we are already having the code written in Python. So basically we can just copy this and make sure that you are already having Python installed on your system. If you don't have Python, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. And here I am in my Visual Studio Code. I'm having here an empty Python file. And apart from that, I'm having here two sample audio files, and this is how it sounds.
But hey, no worries, I got you. Let me just pull up your...
So basically we are going to convert this into text format. And here we can just paste the code that we had copied earlier. So this one. And now we need to add the OpenAI API key. So for that, we already saw this API keys, right? So click on create new secret key, and you can just name it something, select the project and create secret key. Copy it, and if you want to delete it, you can delete it. So don't share this key to anyone. And here you'll be having this OpenAI object thing, right? So inside that, just type API underscore key equal to, within double quotes, paste your API key. So this is just for demo purpose. I'm directly hard coding it. It's better to have a separate environment variable file and specifying the key over there. And now we are done with that. Next thing is we need to specify the path to our MP3 file. So here I'm having directly inside the folder where I'm also having my Python. So I will just directly specify the name of my audio file. So it's going to be sample c.mp3. So this is going to be the name of my audio file. And here we need to change the model because it's using Whisper 1. So this also works, but we are more interested in GPT-4o transcribe or GPT-4o mini transcribe, because GPT-4o transcribe is the latest model and it has better benchmarks and accuracy than Whisper 1. So just change the model to GPT-4o transcribe or mini, and after this, here we will be getting the response, and we are just printing the text, which is the transcription of this audio file. So save it. And another important thing, we need to install the OpenAI package. So it's going to be pip install space OpenAI and hit enter. I have already installed OpenAI package. And the thing is, if you already have OpenAI library installed on your system, make sure that you are upgrading it to the latest version. So if I go and run the command pip list. So here I am having OpenAI. Yeah, I guess 1.68 is the latest version. So if you're using any older version, it will, I guess, throws you some errors. So it's always better to use the upgraded or the latest version of OpenAI. So that's for the existing users. So now to run this, it's going to be Python your filename.py and hit enter. So as you can see here, we have got the text, which is the transcription. So if I play it,
count real quick. All right, looks like the system flagged some charges.
So looks like the system flagged some charges. So we're having the exact transcription. So now let's see how we can use this particular code from Postman. Imagine I'm sending the MP3 file from my Postman and the user is receiving it and sending back the text as the response. So let's see how we can do that. So for creating a REST endpoint, we will be using the Flask Python package. So it's going to be pip install Flask. Make sure that you're installing it. And after that, you need to import it. It's going to be from Flask import Flask, comma, request, comma, JSONify. So basically we will be importing these three things from Flask. And next we'll be creating the Flask variable. So it's going to be app equal to Flask, and you'll be having underscore underscore name underscore underscore. And after this, we will just leave this stuff over here, and we need to put this entire code inside our endpoint. So we'll be creating our endpoint. So it's going to be at app in smaller cases dot route, and here we need to specify the path. So it's going to be, I'll just have it as convert audio, something like this. And next we need to specify the type of our operation. So in our case, it's going to be of type post. So it's going to be methods equal to square bracket, and inside that, within single quotes, specify it as post operation. That's it. And next we need to have the function. So it's going to be define, and we can just name it as convert audio, something like this. We'll have our function, and now we can just get our audio file, because from Postman in body form data we'll be sending our audio file. So I'll just write the code how we will fetch the audio file from Postman and later explain you. So it's going to be audio underscore file equal to request, which is basically this one that we have imported, dot files within square bracket and single quote, you need to specify it as file. And you can just have a condition. If this file has been sent by the user, you can just have a if condition. If the file is not there, you can just throw an error. You can do those checking. And once you have got the file, next thing is we will be basically storing this file in a temporary path. All right, so we'll be storing it here, and after that we can just remove that particular file. Okay, so let's just create that temporary location, okay, to store the file. So in next line, it's going to be temp underscore path equal to, like, f, we have to put double quotes, it's going to be temp underscore within curly bracket, and inside that we will be having the audio file, this one, put it over here, and we can get the file name. So it's going to be dot file name. All right, so this is going to be the temporary path. This will be getting stored over here, exact same folder. All right, now that we have defined this temporary path, we need to store this particular audio file in this path. So this will be storing here inside the exact same folder. All right, so you need to store this audio file that we sent from Postman in this path. So for that, what we can do is, it's going to be audio file dot save, and we need to specify here temp path. Okay, we need to have this particular path over here. So this saves the MP3 file or whatever the file format inside this particular path. All right, next we can just modify this existing code. We won't be storing it in a variable, rather that it's going to be with, and be careful with the indentation, with open, and here we aren't going to hard code a MP3 file name. Rather than that, we'll be having here temp path. This is the opening type, RB is fine, as file colon, and we need to make sure with the indentation over here also, like, just format this stuff. And inside this, this is going to be the response, and these are fine. And rather than passing here the audio file, we need to pass file, because that's the thing we have opened. So here it's going to be file. Now this transcription variable will have the output, so we just need to send this as a response. But apart from that, we can also remove this temporary path that we have created, because once we send the file, we won't need this temporary path or temporary storage. Okay, we can literally like erase it. So for that, we can just import OS. This is a inbuilt package, and after this with, we can just have this as OS dot remove, which basically deletes that particular MP3 file or the audio file. We need to pass here temp path. That's it. And after this, we can just return the transcription. So just come outside of this with. It's going to be return. We'll be having the JSONify, which is from Flask, circular bracket and curly bracket. And inside that, we can just have a key. Let me call it as text and colon. And now we will be using this response transcription dot text. All right. And if you want, you can just have a try catch block. And if there is any error, you can send the status as 5000. That's up to you. Now just come outside of everything, the starting of the line, outside of the function and the route. Now we will be writing code to start our application. So it's going to be if underscore underscore name space equals to, within single quote, it's going to be underscore underscore main underscore underscore. We can just start our application. So it's going to be app.run, and you can specify the port if you want. By default, it's going to start at port 5000. All right, that's the code, guys. So simple. And now we can start our application. It has started in this particular path. So copy this, go to postman, new path, put it over here, change the operation to post, and you need to put this path here also, convert audio, put it over here. And now you need to go to body, form data. You'll be having the key over here, right? You'll be having a small drop down. Select it and select file over here, and you need to name the key as file. The reason we are naming it file, because here we are having the key as file. So if you change it here, you need to change it here also. Both the things should have the same name. Now click on this select files option under value. So in my case, my file is in desktop. I will just select the file and open it. That's it, that file will be added. Now we can just send it. So here you can see we have got the exact same output that we got a moment ago, because this is the same file that we are sending. It has beautifully converted, and we are getting it in a like a JSON format. And you can just, you know, access it in your use case if you're having a web app or something. And apart from this, they are also having the live streaming feature. You can also try this out. So this is that particular code. So now in our case, we are getting the response only that entire audio file has been completely transcribed to text. Okay, it doesn't send word by word transcription. But here they are having a feature, if a particular word has been transcribed by this model, it will directly send the response. So you can also try this out depending upon your use case. But if you want, let me just run and show you how this works. So I'll just copy this. So now I've just copied that stream thing. So this basically will give us the response instantly for each word that has already transcribed to text. So if I just now run it, so I'll just expand my terminal because it will be like so fast. So run this. So we just saw that, right? We are getting it as a stream word by word like this. So in case if you have any use case like this, if you want the model to send you as soon as the transcribing of a particular part of that audio is done, you can just use this streaming way. All right. So that's the video, guys. I hope you would have found it useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in OpenAI, Gemini AI, API, as well as other CRUD operations and AI tools in general. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.